Welcome back to this channel once again, and in this video session I'll be covering program status data structure, that is PSDS in RPG 4. So PSDS is what basically it avails us, or it avails the RPG program the exceptions which are occurred in the program. So I just created one program where you can see how you can code a PSDS in your RPG program and how you can make use of that. So let me show that. So one PSDS is allowed per module, so every module has only one PSDS. So if you are coding multiple modules, so other PSDS would be required, or you have to code the PSDS there also, or you can keep a PSDS in some copybook and you can use them there. Now you can see for PSDS I give the name to a PSDS, that is PSDS1. You can give any name, and since this is a DS data structure, and here you will be picking S because this is a program status data structure. So for program status data structure you will be using S. So SDS is PSDS. Now these are the, this is the structure of the PSDS. So these are all informations which are available to your program when you are coding a PSDS in your program, in your module. So procedure name, module or program name. So if you have created a module using create rpg mod command, and or you have created the module using create bind rpg command, so in both the cases it is possible that in case of create rpg mod it is possible that the module name would be different than the program name, but in case of create bind rpg a module is created in qtemp and then bound to your program and then deleted. So in that case your module or program name would be same, but in case of create rpg mod it is possible that your module and program may have different name. So either it would contain the module name or the program name. So this is the status which is available to the program whenever any exception, program exception occurs. And here you can see I use star status, and which is 11 to 15 positions and 5,0 zone decimal data type, length is 5,0 and it's zone decimal. So let me show you those exceptions. So I have to show you this program. So let me show you the exceptions. So the normal codes are these one, and these are the exception codes. So 100 is value out of range for string operation. 00102 is divided by 0. 00105 is invalid characters in character to numeric conversion function, and all those things. So there are many status codes. Some of them are listed here and some of them are not. So these status codes will be returned or will be available to the program whenever you are coding a PSDS in this field, pgm underscore status means star status. This is the previous status, this is the source listing line, this is the routine. So this is of 8 characters and from position 29 to 36 position. It could contain star init, detail, get in and all these things. So based upon the execution, program initialization, detail lines, get in, get input called, total calculations, total lines, detail calculations, overflow lines, program ending, which is termination, name of program or procedure called, So star routine would be in case of if you are calling any other program from a program. Params, number of parameters passed, exception type, if it is a operating system exception, so it would be started with CPF, and then a number, and if it is a machine exception, then it's start with MCH, then a number, and this is the number which is coming here with CPF message number or MCH message number. This is the reserve field, work area, PGM lib, exception data, exception cause. All those things are part of the PSDS structure, and you can refer it from even from Google to job name, username, job number, date. So these are the all possible fields. Even unused fields are listed here, as you can see. So all the possible fields which are part of the PSDS are listed here, and you can make use of them in your program. So let me compile this. Debug this program. Add the breakpoint at line number 1, RPGLE 7. Eval PSDS 1. So procedure name is RPGLE 7 star init. This is the program library, easy class 1. Date is 23rd 12 2020, year is 2020, status info is 0, job name, username and job number, date, time, compiler level, source file is RPGLE, source lib is easy class 1, source member, procedure member, module member, and this is source ID, user profile, and all these information, system name is buff 400. So all these informations are available in the PSDS, and you can make use of these information in your code as per your requirement. So this is the end of program. So this is what all about the structure which I'm telling here. So this whole video talks about the structure of the PSDS, what are all fields would be there in the PSDS structure. So yes, we can make use of these things in our program. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have a nice time.